Hello and welcome back to Linux Gamer Till I Die. This is episode 12 of my playthrough of Fallout New Vegas. Now in the previous episode, we spent the entire time trying to complete the, Come Fly With Me side quest. This involved us going down into the basement of the Retcon facility and dealing with the Nightkin. Menace in the halls underneath the main facility. Now, it turns out they were actually looking for a shipment of stealth boys, and the reason why they were still around was because they couldn't gain access to one of the rooms where they believed the stealth boys could be. This room was guarded by a ghoul, can't remember his name, it was Harkin or something like that, who had holed up in there because obviously the Nightkin were attacking. He'd hold up in a good defensive position and was basically keeping them at bay. So they're at a kind of a stalemate situation. Now, he wouldn't leave unless we found the ghoul he had been in companion with. That's a really odd way of saying it. He came down into the basement with another ghoul, and that ghoul went the wrong direction and got lost after the Nightkin attacked, and he wanted us to find her for him so that he would leave and then the Nightkin could come in, and yeah, it was a mess. We accidentally made that guy hostile by going upstairs without finding his friend, and I think it was either Edie or Boone just murdered him. Pretty much one-shotted. So we skipped that part of the side quest, which means one of the doors is currently locked in the basement that we can't get through. I've researched it and apparently there is a spare key which we might have a look for before we disappear from this area. But I'm not going to spend too long looking for that, I don't think there's going to be much down there. But yeah, we found out that the shipment of stealth boys was sent to this facility in mistake and was subsequently shipped back out before the war or the bombs ever hit. So the Nightkin have moved on to look elsewhere. Following on from that, we managed to convince Chris that he was human, but he agreed that he would continue to help the ghouls, and then afterwards he would go to Novak and live there. We acquired a load of miniature rockets for him, which we kind of already acquired because I stole them. Shh. And we needed to reclaim a couple of sensor modules, I think it was, which old Lady Gibson agreed to sell us for 250 caps after we passed a speech check. With these components, we managed to repair the spaceships, or the rocket ships that Jason Blight and his companions were trying to use, and at the end of the episode we saw them take off, but then my game crashed, so we didn't actually get any experience for it, and we didn't save the game. So at the beginning of this episode we're actually going to redo the fixing of the coordinates and firing of the rocket ships. And then we'll get the reputation bonus and the XP for completing the quest. So let's load up the save and let's do that. Wow, I spent 4 minutes talking about that. So yeah, we've come back up to the viewing platform. This is before we fire the rockets. We're gonna do this again. Make the change to fix the course, get car for that. Didn't notice that last time. And we're going to press the launch button. I'm not going to try and open our pit boy to turn the music on this time. So hopefully it doesn't freeze afterwards. It's kind of a weird freeze before. I think possibly pressing tab after it told me the music was there. Fuck things up. There we go. The rockets have flown away. Now Novak likes us. But now the music cuts in. So we gained a level up. And I'm not sure what we're going to spend it on. I suppose energy weapons, because we've got shit tons of ammo for our plasma pistol. A few more for sneak. And even more for speech. And that'll do. We also get to choose a perk. That's a good good level up. So I think I'm going to go with intense training again, and I'm going to put it into strength. So can we turn that off now? Probably not. It's just playing in the background. Oh, I hope that isn't going to stick with us for the rest of the game. Thank fuck for that. Alright, so, like I said, I'm going to go downstairs and try and find a key for the one room that we weren't able to explore previously. Yes, I know, I've cheated again, and now it's crashed. Yep. Bear with. But yes, I've cheated again and looked up online to see if we can get in that room. As it turns out, we can get in that room. But we need to find the key, which is apparently in the room above the locked room. In a desk, so that should be easy enough to find if it's there. If not, we won't have to spend too long looking for it. Right, loaded up my save. Been very crashy last episode. I thought that crash during the spaceship launch would be a one-off, just because it's such a unique event. But seems the game's just feeling a bit temperamental today. Sounds like we still got static. Okay, so there's a locked door. Should be a room up here with a table in it. Maybe over here. Which has a key either in it or on it. Also stuck. Keys in this game are particularly big, so it should be fairly obvious once we see it. Oh. Have all that. Jail key. Well, there we go. That's easy. And it was just a case of me not looking properly last time I was here. Eh well. Now we can get through here and hopefully find the other ghoul, who I'm pretty sure is dead because we can't see any life. There she is. Never mind. This is not an honour. Might be something in the other rooms. I'm not holding my breath. Absolutely nothing. Well, that was a waste of time. Never mind. I don't think we would have got to here to rescue that person, even if they were alive, back when the Nightkins were around, because they were tough to kill. Only had to deal with one of them. And it took, like, an entire clip of plasma rounds, plus whatever Edie was doing, and Boone. So we would have struggled to defeat them all, I think. They looked like there was quite a few of them. Anyway, we have successfully cleared the retcon facility. Now, it's crashed again, hasn't it? Hold on. This is really not going well. Two crashes in 12 minutes. And for four of that, I was talking. Hopefully, once we get out of this facility, it'll be a little bit more stable. And we're going to head to Novak once we get out, and we're going to go see if we can find Chris. Don't crash. Terrified of looking in certain directions now. No, not that way. Pretty sure there is a door over here actually. There's the main door. We are out. And now, we never need to come here again. Okay, you're gonna have to bear with me a second here. The OBS window is directly above the Fallout New Vegas window, and it's making it very jarring whenever I move inside New Vegas. Right, there we go. Sorry for that. So I have a 2550x1920 resolution or something bizarre like that, which allows me to have a 1920x1080 window inside of it, which is what I record. But depending on the placements of the windows, yeah, we weren't there before. Depending on the placement of windows, I get OBS showing part of the screen behind the window in which I'm actually playing, and it causes my eyes to bleed. You'll notice me quicksaving a lot now that I'm outside and the game's been so crashy. So the game auto saves every time you go from one environment to another, but when you're walking outside, it can be ages between areas. I don't want to be walking for 20 minutes only for the game to crash and we have to re-walk. See if we can find Chris. I have no idea where he'll be. I would hazard a guess somewhere around this area. That's a hole in the wall. Is it a hole in the wall? Yes, it is a hole in the wall. All that stuff is owned by someone. As is that stuff.
Howdy.
Some pre-war books. I don't know if they're worth anything in this game. Ooh, a lot of drugs going on in here. There's a living legend himself.
Howdy. Fine weather for flying. It's times like these that make me miss it all. Vertibird pilot. 71 missions and only lost one chopper. Rotor malfunction over Klamath. Hard landing, but I walked away. I help folks strip down the more complicated bits of salvage they bring in. Engines, mostly. The bits and pieces we take out are usually worth more than the whole thing put together. Four? No, not exactly. It was a long time ago. Things are a lot different these days, and those days are way behind me.
All right.
Watch your six out there.
Good advice. I don't know how he missed her the first time we came here. Guess the room was locked or something. Well, I'm confused. No idea where this guy is.
Howdy.
Maybe he didn't come here after all. Don't get up. Yeah, I'm still not dealing with that.
If you like news, you're gonna love our next segment.
I don't know if you know, but since Jeannie May passed, I've been keeping an eye on her properties for her. I think it's time we gave everything back to you, so take this key and make yourself at home at our motel.
Word on
It'll open the room on the second floor, closest to the lobby. Hope it suits you.
Huh. I mean, we already had that key. Not gonna say that.
Really? I never thought I'd see the day. I mean, the day I'd part with them for such an incredibly low price, with so many other offers flooding in. But I like you. I think maybe it's time. All that's left is in the storage room here. You can buy the key from my store. Sure thing. Have a look.
Apparently we can buy the key to that cupboard. Never knew that. It's cheap as chips as well. Oh, well, I feel bad for stealing. Still not going to say that.
Come back soon now.
They'll weigh something, so I'm not going to take them. But I stole all the rocket ships from here. Oh well. Let's see what we have left to accomplish around this area. I can hear, so if Chris is milling. Log. Eating my love. He went that away. I'm pretty sure we had a quest for maybe it was a missed quest. No. Maybe it's I don't know. But I'm sure we had a quest to check on the ranger people. Guess it's not an actual quest. Maybe it's just a request. Yeah, okay, I can't find Chris anywhere. Maybe he didn't come here after all. I think he's meant to. Maybe he turns up later on.
Hey there.
So, I'm going to give up on looking for him. Let's continue with our... Let's see if we get a quest marker for this. No. We can't really target that quest, but we can do this quest. Which will take us towards Helios 1. No, not towards Boulder City. So, I guess we'll head that way. Right, so we now have a carry weight of 220, which will drop down to 200 when we go inside. So we're not near on limit at the moment. So we don't need to do any trading. Head over towards that. That's Helios 1. Yeah, maybe not. I seem to remember there's a big fight at Helios 1 involving the NCR. And I don't really want to get involved in that right now. That takes me towards it. Seems to be coming across a lot of red markers here. Vipers, even. With an egg timer. Because, of course. And she's got a full cutlery reset here. Fork, knife, and spoon. She came prepared. Somebody behind here. Cannot see him through the hole though, so it must be further away. Laser pistol. Yes, we have full quality laser pistol. How much these weigh? 6. Well, we can repair these. And sell them when we next come across the trader. Guess we don't need to crouch in here. I'll have our weapon drawn. Dirty water. Where's Boone? Oh, he's hiding in the corner there. We'll take the dirty water and the stim pack and the missiles and 12 gauge. Like I've previously said, I think missiles don't actually weigh anything in the mode I'm playing, but in survival, I think it is. They weigh something like 5 each, so if you're going to carry around a rocket launcher, you quickly become over encumbered with your ammo. Where these things are. Maybe blowflies. In which case we don't need to worry about them, they're miles away. Let's continue along the road. That's a whole lot of ants. I don't think they will be of any problem to us so long as we stay away from them. There's a huge ant over there. There. Okay, this is an NPC that we can talk to. When he wakes up, I guess we can wake him up.
Howdy there, partner.
He looks so tired.
Oh, this old thing? Why, thanks, friend. This here guitar is just about the only thing my daddy left me. Long time ago now. I never even knew him. Ma always said he was a mysterious fella, always traveling on in secret. My story's a long one, friend, and I can't say as it's all that interesting. Well, I was born in a little town out Montana way. Me and Ma didn't have much ever since my pa up and left. That he did. Never did know why. Ma always said he was a real mysterious fella, even when he was with her. Like he was a stranger sometimes. Maybe. Maybe I just never felt like I belonged back home. It sure wasn't easy. Ma worked her fingers to the bone to make sure we had enough to survive. And I worked the coal mines from when I was 15. After Ma died, I guess I wanted to find my pa and get some answers from him. Been out here looking ever since, but he ain't an easy man to find.
So I think it's the mysterious stranger, and that's a perk you can unlock if you have a certain amount of luck, I think. Basically some guy that shows up randomly and helps you when you're shooting things and that.
Can't say as I really know. Maybe I'll just ask him why. Maybe I'll punch him right in the mouth. Hell, the more I talk about it, the more the whole damn thing sounds like a dumb idea. Maybe I should. Don't suppose you know any place a fella with a guitar might find a job, huh? Ah, well, it was worth a shot. So long, friend.
That's a nice little conversation we had there. Completely pointless, but meh. A lot of interactions are pointless. Doesn't mean you should avoid them. So we need to head in that direction. I don't want to deviate from the road too much, because that's where you find the really strong monsters. The city, that's where we're heading. Now, from what I remember, Boulder City is pretty fucked. Like, it's a wasteland. It was a scene of a battle between the NCR and Caesar's Legion, and I can't remember who it was, but one of them decided to blow up town in order to keep it out of the hands of the other. At least that's what I think it is. I heard a dog. Oops, nope, wrong button. There we go. Don't win another damn minute. Rangers, give them hell. Oh, scorpions. No chance. Yeah. Huh, that was lucky. That wasn't so lucky. Don't you need any more drinks? Well, that was pretty pointless. Not convinced there's anything we can do around this bit either. There's nothing but good stuff in there. Bullshit. Don't want to fall off. We can't get in there. That was actually quite a nice find. So I didn't actually want to pick up the lunchbox there. Too used to playing Fallout 4 where you can open the lunch boxes without picking them up. They have something inside them. In this game, they're nothing but dead weight. I think you can turn them into bottle cap mines, but I generally don't. So we have made it to Boulder City. And by the look of it, it's still smoking. And there's a fire going, that's why. So basically, these guys gave their lives to defend the city from the approach of the legionaries, called Caesar's Legion. And they got killed in an explosion that the NCR set off. There's not a whole lot in this town worth taking. looks like we're coming pretty close to our limit here. Might need to give some stuff to Boone or Edie. But let's have a quick organization.
Fine by me.
I'm glad you agree. I don't need a 10mm and 9mm. You can have that. I guess I'll give you that as well because I've got a silenced 10mm. Ranger's hat doesn't really do anything, so I may as well drop that. Well, it doesn't really take up any weight either. In fact, it's pretty much just nothing. It doesn't weigh anything, doesn't have any damage rating, it doesn't have any value, doesn't have any effects. It's, yeah, pointless. I'll keep all that for now. I guess I'll give you 4 of these. Maybe 9. I'll keep 5. That'll probably do for the moment. Entirely sure what's taking up all my inventory space anyway.
We've got a situation with some great cons right now. The brass at McCarran has ordered me to lock down the ruins until it's been resolved. One of my patrols was on its way back from Novak when it came under fire from the great cons. They radioed for reinforcements, but instead of waiting for us, they chased the cons into the ruins where they were caught in a crossfire. No deaths, but not all the squad got out. The cons have Private Ackerman and Private Gilbert as hostages. Once the Great Khans have been killed or captured, you're welcome to retrieve any property they've taken from you. Normally I'd turn you down since I have no idea who you are, but considering that the hostages are as good as dead when we attack... Alright, I'm going to give you a chance to talk to the Great Khans. Their leader is a man named Jessup. If we hear shooting, we'll be coming in, but it'll probably be too late for you. Good luck.
So, how does this guy know what the guy's name is? Right. This is usually a crashy bit. Basically, we enter the ruins, which is a separate area, and then we need to get to where the Great Khans are hiding. Can I tell you to wait here? Same with you.
I'll sit tight.
Man, this place is a mess.
So we can resolve this situation diplomatically. But it requires bit of sneaking. Bit of skill and a lot of luck, if I remember right. Police stories, what's that? Ooh, gives me critical chance. I think that's the building we need to go to. So maybe it's not that difficult after all. If you try and go in the normal way, you end up drawing the... Actually, I think we have one of those. Drawing the fire of the Great Khans, and you end up having to shoot them all. So I think it's more than just the two that you saw at the beginning of the game. I think there's a few more lurking around. Can't remember if they set traps as well. Maybe not that door. Then again, maybe it is, because there's no other doors to open.
The NCR sure did a number on this place.
So I'm not sure if this counts as inside or outside. Let me check my stats. Apparently it counts as outside, so we do have speech of 55. Which maybe.
Man, I'm sick of this place. Can't wait to get back to Red Rock.
Maybe high enough for me to bargain with these guys. Check how many skill books we have. If we've got something that improves speech, might be worth reading that. Maybe worth using Mentats as well. I'm gonna hold on to that for the moment.
What the hell? You're that courier Benny wasted back in Good Springs. You're supposed to be dead. And here I thought us Great Khans were tough to kill. So, what happens now? Don't have it. Benny stole it right before he stabbed us in the back. He's probably back at the strip by now, laughing at me.
Hey, level up.
Yeah? On what? He's one of the chairmen, big shots that run the Topps Casino in New Vegas. A friend from the city contacted me with info on a big job. I should have known that the caps were too good to be true, but there was still no way I could pass up the chance. He's a snake, that's why. He owed us the rest of the pay for the job, so maybe he didn't want to pay up. Just a big fancy poker chip, as far as I know. Don't know why anyone would make one out of platinum, though. Fine. What's to negotiate? The NCR backs off, we walk out of here, nobody gets hurt. I can't believe I'm doing this. But all right, the hostages can go. The NCR had better keep their end of the deal, though. Here, a souvenir for you. It's Benny's lighter. Shove it up his ass when you catch up with him.
Heh.
Yeah, go on.
Cool. Successfully resolved that situation. And got another level up. So, let's see. Let's increase energy weapons a bit more. Speech a bit more. Lockpick. And that'll probably do. Don't get to steal anything until they leave.
Fuck Benny. We'll make him pay for stabbing us in the back.
Oh dear, McMurphy died. Yoink, 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 yoink. Pretty sure we can just leave now. Along.
I've got your back.
Oh. Wait, come back here, you.
Thanks for the rescue.
Well, apparently we did rescue them.
I'm glad you're able to get my people freed, but there's a new problem. I just got orders to take out the Great Khans, hostages or not. My hands are tied. I can't go against orders, can I? You're right. The Great Khans are free to go.
Hey, apparently the Great Khans like me as well.
I really don't have time to chatter right now. Shoot.
You don't have time, but you're going to answer questions?
It's one of the biggest sources of electrical power in the region, so the NCR's fortified the place pretty heavily. When President Kimball shows up on his inspection tour, I'm sure he'll be confident that the dam's safe and secure. Destroyed during the Battle of Hoover Dam a couple years ago, the town was set up as a trap for Caesar's Legion. The sharpshooters and the Rangers picked off the Legion's veterans from a distance, and the rest of the Legion just rushed on in. And boom. Camp McCarran is the headquarters for the NCR military in this region. It occupies the old airport next to New Vegas. It's probably just a political thing. You know, give a few speeches, shake hands with the troops, boost morale. They're an outlaw group primarily trafficking in drugs and other contraband. They usually stay out of NCR territory, though. All right. Sir?
All right, then.
Man, I thought I was dead for sure.
So, we've saved Benny and the other... No, not Benny. Jessup, was it? We've saved Jessup and the other Great Khans from being exterminated by the NCR. Not sure why, but it seemed like the right thing to do, because, yeah, they didn't kill their hostages. He's just wandering off into the desert. Fine. We got a new quest from completing that quest, which is going to take us to the Strip, which is here-ish. What is our actual quest? Confront Benny. So, we've already managed to progress this quest far enough to meet up with the person who shot us in the head. He seemed quite apologetic at the time, but I guess we'll find out why he did what he did. Not sure if we can do anything with this train.
Fancy meeting you here, friend!
What? Where the fuck did you come from?
Just rolling along on my spurs. Looks like I just might make it to New Vegas after all. Yep. Guess it's just down to you and Fancy Pants. I wouldn't worry about him. He looks all hat and no cattle, if you ask me. this is getting mighty embarrassing. People gonna start to talk. Fancy pants? No, I ain't seen hiding a hair of him since the tussle in Good Springs. I'm sure he ran back to the soft living of New Vegas, though. Look me up when you get to New Vegas. I'll buy the first round.
I don't know if we can just follow him to New Vegas, to be honest. Where's he going? Certainly taking a weird route. In fact, I'm not sure he's even going to move any further.
Fancy meeting you here, friend. Look me up when you...
Are you just going to stand there? Yeah, I guess we weren't meant to follow him. I think he's just meant to disappear. Head this way, follow the road up. On the train track. Boulder City. Seems to be a lot of people over here. It's not Camp McCarran, is it? Nope, it's just a random place. It's NCR owned. Trading post.
Welcome to the 188 Slopping Shop. Like our slogan says, it's better than nothing. You bet.
Alright, now we can do some selling. Do I have a 10mm? No. I think we gave it to Boone. Sell a few of these, we don't need 12 of them. Let me nuke a cola. Yeah, we've got 5 of them, that's fine. Not sure we need 10 stealth boys. Sell 6 of them. Oh, maybe not. Overestimated the amount of money this guy has. Sell 2 of them. Let's see what this guy actually has to sell. A whole lot of nothing. Cool. You're useless.
Samuel Kerr at your service. Me and my daughter Michelle run this fine establishment. We came here from Prim about a month past. Doesn't look like much, but it's one hell of a location. Michelle and I ran a little shop in Prim till a prison break north of town spoiled it for everyone. Goddamn convicts just about shut down I-15. When traffic dried up, we took to our heels to find us some customers. I'm not one to sit around waiting to get saved, and Michelle ain't neither.
All right.
When 15 shut down, 95 became the route NCR citizens used to get to the Strip, or limp back home, after the Strip's drained them of caps. We get them coming and going. Coming, the suckers flush with caps they saved to gamble on the Strip. And going, the same folks, but now they're losers who'll trade you the shirt off their backs so they don't starve before they make it back home. Add in the troopers marching back and forth from McCarran and the Dam, and well, let's just say we don't miss Prim.
Fair enough.
Let me see what I can do.
Have I got anything that needs repairing? That's going to cost 5 caps to do fuck all to it. Not doing that. It's going to cost 8 caps to give +2 condition. Nah, may as well. That's going to cost shit tons. What? Why? Yeah, we're not going to spend 5,000 caps repairing everything. Goodbye. Alright.
Welcome to the 188 Sloppin' Shop. How can I help you? Have a look.
Yeah, she's got the same inventory, so not much point.
Name's Michelle. My dad and me run this store. His name's Samuel. I take the day shift and he takes nights. We came here about a month ago when Prim went to hell on account of the prison break north of there. Found a bin to call home and set up shop. There's more to the 188 than meets the eye. Troops move back and forth on 93 all the time, and 95 is how NCR folks come and go from Vegas. No shortage of customers, so long as Legion raids south of here don't get worse anyways. You do know these old roads were numbered, right? We're standing where the 95 and 93 meet, and 95 plus 93 equals 188.
Makes sense.
Not much. I hear some folks got killed down by Nelson. Or was it Novak? I don't know. If they come up this way, me and Dad'll go someplace else. Later.
Your voice suddenly changed at the end of that.
Hey. No offense, but you look like you've traveled a long way down some bad roads. Where'd you come from? Huh. Well, in that case, I take it back. You look pretty good, given the circumstances. Well, welcome then. I'm Veronica. I live in a hole in the ground. Well, a bunker, if you want to get technical. I think it sounds more interesting my way. But I'm not there much anymore. I'm usually out here picking up food and supplies for my family, whatever they need. Yeah, I'm not worried. They can handle themselves. But somebody has to get the groceries, know what I mean? And actually, these days, I think they'd rather have me out here anyway. But that's a whole other story. So, listen, can I ask you something on the level? I had a run-in with this group calling themselves the Brotherhood of Steel. Pretty strange bunch. Do you know anything about them? Well, that shouldn't be a problem for me. I can't afford anything like that. Hey, so, where are you headed anyway?
Guess we'll go with that.
This is quite a journey you're going on, then. Must be an interesting relationship to have brought you all this way. I'll be honest. You're the first person I've run across out here that looks like he can really handle himself. There are places I've never been to that'd be too dangerous for just me. What do you think? Maybe we could travel together. Help each other out. Like I said, they can handle themselves. And I'm not the only one getting supplies for them. It's a big family.
So she's a member of the Brotherhood of Steel. She's reconnaissance or something, I guess. By a hole in the ground, she's talking about the Brotherhood of Steel's bunker, which is where the entirety of the Brotherhood of Steel live in this game. see what else you can tell us.
Good. That's the look I was going for. Trust me on this one, though. You'll be glad you brought me along. If I turn out to be a burden, we can part ways at any time. No hard feelings. Oh, nowhere in particular, really. Just hoping to see more of the world. Looking for a fresh perspective. I want to see how different groups have adapted to survive in the Mojave. See if there's something I can learn from. Aw, you really know how to make a girl feel like a stray cat. But, okay, my offer stands. If we run into each other again.
So, we can ask Boone to leave our service.
Fine by me.
Well, to do that, I want to take all my stuff back. I don't want his beret, I don't think. Did I collect his beret? Where the hell did you find those? Did I give you those? Yeah, I'm not sure what happened to his beret. Maybe it's that one. And it's just duplicated and I've just unduplicated it.
I'd really like my beret back, please.
You've done a good turn for the NCR, and now we'd like to do one for you. There's an NCR emergency two-way radio. You call, and we'll come running. You're not alone out here. The NCR has your back. Stay safe and good hunting.
Hello.
All right, that was weird.
Fine by me.
Can I give him his beret back now? Ah, yeah, okay. Apparently we had two of them. They just stack them for some reason.
Couldn't get enough of talking to me the first time, huh? Good. I'd hoped you'd come around. Shall we? Aw.
Okay, we need to ask Boone to leave us first.
What is it? Okay. No, it doesn't. All right. It's NCR land for the most part. We tamed it. Now we're settling it. A lot of people complain about it, but they forget what it was like before we showed up. It's a lot of territory to secure. Too much, even for a big army like the NCR's. Okay. Coming east was about securing the land so people could live without fear. It's not always that simple, but I think the cause is still right. And God help us if they lose. Okay. Yeah, lots of thoughts. All about the best ways to kill them. Yeah.
So, we need to ask him to leave.
What is it? If that's what you think. Alright. Guess I'll be around Novak for a while longer until I figure out what I want to do with myself. See you around.
Ooh, we lose Spotter Perk. But now we can recruit.
Didn't get enough of talking to me the first time, huh?
Veronica. Who is.
Good. I'd hoped you'd come around, shall we?
Like I mentioned, a Brotherhood of Steel scribe, I think.
Now you're talking. One thing you should know first, though. I ask you about the Brotherhood because I'm one of them. I know, but I had to know how you'd react when I told you. We have made a lot of enemies. You still okay bringing me along? I'm great at punching people. I'm not gonna lie. It's a gift. Well, thanks for taking a chance on a naive young girl from California with stars in her eyes and a pneumatic gauntlet on her hand. Let's hit the road, huh?
Let's see what that perk is. And then I really need to save us. We're at the 1 hour 10 minute mark. Stats. Perks. Scribe assistance. So basically she acts like Edie. I need to trade her some stuff.
You're making me carry the heavy stuff, aren't you?
Yep. Can repair those, so I'll hold them for the moment. Don't need this many frag grenades. You can have 5. Same with the mines, you can have 12. You're pretty good with a laser rifle, but it's not very good quality. I'll give you a laser pistol. I think I'll repair those. Oh, she's put on a gauntlet. Apparently she is good at melee. Not sure if I want to give her a spacesuit. Can't be any worse than what she's currently wearing.
Does jumping at them with my fists count as ranged? Yes! Finally! Everything is coming up for Ronica. Ooh, got something good for me? Is it a dress?
No, I just want you to carry a load of stuff. I think the Plasma Defender's pretty good. This is the same ammo as the pistol, so we might try that next episode. Give you that. If it's better than what you're wearing, you can equip it. But otherwise, I don't really care. We should have a load of water, I think. Purified water. Let's give you 11 of that. I'll also give you the 530 water. And 5 atomic cocktails. That brings our weight down pretty substantially, so. She looks ridiculous. I guess we're gonna leave the episode here for today. So let's save. Overwrite the retcon save. And then let's leave the episode here for today. So, in this episode we've finally got out of the retcon facility. And we never need to go back. Hooray! No sign of Chris, who said he was going to go to Novak. But I'm not too worried about that. He'll turn up when he wants fed. We've made our way to Boulder City and negotiated a exchange of hostages, I guess, in the NCR hostages from the Great Khan's and trade for the Great Khan's safe passage out of Boulder City. It's a weird situation. Basically, they were betrayed by Benny, who shot us in the head and is now heading back to the new strip on Vegas. They got themselves into a situation where they were surrounded by the NCR, but neither could really make a move, so we managed to get in and negotiate a exchange, basically. So the Great Khans like us, the NCR likes us, and we're coming for Benny. It's basically the summary of this episode. In the next episode, we'll start by chatting with Veronica, find out who she is, what she wants to do, basically what we did with Boone. I'm going to miss Boone's ability, but yeah. I think once we've unlocked enough of Veronica's talking tree, we'll get access to the Brotherhood of Steel proper, so that's something to look forward to. So until the next episode, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye for now. See you again soon.